In this video, I will explain you how to generate the report with the help of wizard. Wizard means you need to provide the answers of some questions, and after that, report will be generated automatically for you. So before showing you this example, let me tell you what kind of report I am interested in. On each and every page of the report, I want to show the product category. For example, accessories is one of the product categories. And that details of the accessories I want to display on page number one. Then another product category is bikes. And I want to display the details of the bikes on different page. Then I have clothing category, and after that I have components category. All these categories I want to display on different pages. Within each category I have different subcategories. For example, I have mountain bikes, which is one of the subcategories. Then I have road bikes and I have touring bikes. You see, I have plus signs here. If I expand the mountain bikes, then I can see different colors of the mountain bikes. For example, black color, blue color, and different colors. So if I further expand the black color or blue color, let's say if I expand the blue color, I can see the details of the product. So what kind of blue color bike products I have, what kind of black color bike products I have, and so on. So this kind of report I want to generate, and I want to generate this kind of report in the sorted order. Sorted order means, you see, I am showing the categories in the alphabetical order, like A, B, C, and so on. In the same way, I want to sort the subcategories as well. For example, if you see, this is also sorted. First is M, then R, then T. So this is sorted. Then colors should also be sorted, like black, then blue. So the coloring should be sorted. And if I have the product details, so those product details will also be sorted based on the product names. So first I want to sort based on the category. Then I want to sort the data based on subcategory. Then I want to sort the data based on color. And after that, I want to sort the data based on product name. So this kind of report I want to generate, and I will generate this report with the help of wizard. I will not manually create this report. So before generating the report, I want to show you from where I will be going to use the data of this particular report. So for that, what I will do, I'll go to SQL Server Management Studio. So under AdventureWorks Data Warehouse, I will use these three tables. One is product category, other one is product subcategory, and third one is product. If I execute all these three tables, so you see, I have only four product categories, which is bikes, component, clothing, and accessories. Here, you see, this is the primary key, and this is the foreign key. So here the primary key is working as foreign key in here. So you see, this is product category 1, and here 111 is working as a foreign key. So for the product category bikes, mountain bikes, road bikes, and touring bikes are the subcategories. And after that, I have the details of the product. If I see the details of the products, so you see, this is the primary key of the product subcategory, and this is the foreign key here. Here some of the values are nulls. It means these products does not belong to any of the subcategories, because these are the nut bolts kind of thing and ball bearing kind of things. So these are actually not the products of any of these categories. That is why it is null. But I am interested in the actual products which the company sells, like bikes, clothing, accessories, etc. So for example, you see this particular product, Spose 100 helmet, it belongs to the subcategory number 31. And if you see the 31 subcategory ID, so this is actually helmet, and helmet belong to 4 product category, which is accessories. So this particular product belongs to the accessories category and helmet subcategory. So actually I need to join these three tables, and after joining these three tables, I will get one result set, and based on the result set, I need to generate the report. So how to generate this kind of report, that I will be show you using SQL Server data tools. So now what I will do, I'll click on start and type Visual Studio. So I click on Visual Studio, in bracket SSDT should appear. So I click here. Now I'll go to file, new project. Make sure reporting services is selected, and I will generate the report with the help of wizard. And I will call this as product details report. And after that, I stick to the default options such as the location. If you want to change these locations, you can do that. Otherwise, stick to the default options and click OK. So what will happen after that, a wizard will be open. So you just need to click next. It is asking me the data source. Data source means from which source you want to bring the data. Whether you want to bring the data from SQL Server, Oracle, Teradata, SAP, Azure, and many other options. So I'm interested in SQL Server because from SQL Server I will be going to bring the data. So I will click on edit here, and it is asking me the server name because it is my local machine, and from the local computer I am fetching the data. So I put dot, and it is asking me the database name. So what I will do, I will choose AdventureWorks Data Warehouse. And after that, I will test the connection. So my connection is successful, and now I can click OK. And after that, I will be going to click next. Then it is asking me to build a query. So what I will do, I will click on Query Builder. So I right click and click on Add Tables. And the table which I will be going to use is DIM product category. Then I will add DIM product subcategory, and then I will add DIM product. So here, if you notice, this is the primary key of the DIM product, this is the primary key of DIM product subcategory, and this is the primary key of DIM product, and there is a relationship. And you see, automatically DIM product is joined with DIM product subcategory on the basis of product category key and of DIM product category, and product category key of DIM product subcategory, and it is further joined with DIM product. How it identified these keys automatically? Because there is primary key and foreign key already defined in the SQL Server database between the tables. So how to check that? What I can do, I will go back to SQL Server Management Studio again, and suppose if I select the table which is DIM product subcategory, make sure AdventureWorks DW is highlighted, and I will use a shortcut key which is Alt plus F1. When I will press Alt plus F1, it will give me the structure of this particular table. So you see, it will give me all the column details, but at the moment I am not interested in all the names of the columns. Here I am interested in this option which is foreign key option. And here if you see, product category key is a foreign key, and this product category key is coming from DIM product category, which is the main table. So from the DIM product category, which is a primary key, here in this particular table it is working as a foreign key. So from using Alt plus F1, you can find out which is a primary key, which is a foreign key, the data types of the columns, whether any column is identity column or not, it means it is auto-generated column or not. So all these things you can identify from here. So I go back to my Visual Studio. So because primary key foreign key is already defined under SQL Server Database engine, that is why these relationships are appearing. Now what I will do, I will check English product category name because it will show me the category name. From here I will check English product subcategory name, and from here let me expand it a bit, and from here I will check first color, and after that I will check English product name, and I am interested in list prices of the products, size of the product, model number of the product, weight of the product, product key also I am including. So all these information I have included. Now you see, this is a very big name, which is English product category name. I just want to call it as category, so I will change it to category. So whatever the columns I have checked, it has already started appearing in here. And you see, because I have labeled this English product category name as category, so you see, you can see as category here. I will call it as subcategory. So you see, automatically this particular column is labeled as subcategory. After that, English product name to just products. Now I want to perform the sorting. So first I will sort based on the English product category name. So I will say sort in ascending order. So this is the sort order 1. Then I want to sort by subcategory. So it is order number 2. Then I want to sort by color. So I can put 3 here. So you can do like that also. And after that, I want to sort by the product names. So you see, at the end, automatically order by category, subcategory, dim product, color, and products appeared. So you see, a query is generated. If you click on run, you will get the output in your desired manner. Then I will click OK. So you see, my query is created. After that, I will click next. Now, what kind of report you are interested in? Whether you are interested in tabular report and whether you are interested in matrix report. Tabular report will give you detailed data, but matrix report will give you summary data. At the moment, I am interested in detailed data, so I will use the tabular report. Later on in this course, you will come to know what is the relevance of matrix report and how to create that. So I click next. Now there are many parts which are appearing: page section, group section, and details section. I told you that I want to display the category on each and every page. Like accessories category should come on page number 1, bike category should come on page number 2, clothing category should come on page number 3. Then subcategory and color I will put in the group section, and product key and rest of the details I will put in the details section. If you want to move the things above and below, then you can use these arrows. For example, this size should come at the bottom, so I can put like this. Now if I click on group, then you see these sections are highlighted, which is group. Group contains the things which can further be expanded. Let's say I am interested in bikes category. So bikes category has 3 subcategories, which are mountain bike, road bike, and touring bike. So mountain bike does not come in only a single color, it comes in multiple colors. So you see, mountain bike can further be expanded to black color, blue color, yellow color, and so on. And colors can also be further expanded in their details. For example, black color has multiple products. So the things or the columns which cannot further be expanded, I have put it in the details section. There are individual products. Now you cannot further break the individual product into sub-product. So that is the lowest level I have. So that is why I put it in the detail section. But subcategory can be expanded to colors, and colors can be expanded to the product details. So that is why I put it in the group section. If you want to put the category in the group section, you can do that, but I don't want to display it in the group level. I want to display every category on different page. Now what I will do, I will click next. Now, what kind of report you are interested in? Stepped report, or you want to display in the blocks like this. But if you generate the report in the blocks, then you cannot use this option, which is enable drill down. If you want to use this option, then you have to use stepped, and then you can check this enable drill down. Drill down feature will give you expand and collapse, like plus minus button it will give you. So if you expand mountain bikes, you will be able to see the colors of that particular subcategory. If you expand the color, then you will be able to see the product details. So that expand collapse option will be provided using enable drill down option. You can also check include subtotals, but at the moment I don't have any numeric data available, so there is no point to check this. Then I click next, and it is asking me to give the name of the report. So I will say product details, and I will check this option preview report and click on finish. So you see accessories is appearing on page number one, then bikes is appearing, which is another category, on page number two. Clothing is appearing on another page, and components are appearing on another page. So you see all the categories are sorted in alphabetical order A, B, C. Now under bikes, subcategories are also sorted in alphabetical order. If I expand road bikes, so you see these are the colors which are also sorted in alphabetical order. If I am interested in yellow color bikes, so these are the yellow color bikes details available here, and so on. So in this way, with the help of wizard, you can generate the report. Now you see this mountain bikes is not coming in one line, and these product names are also not appearing in single line. For that, what I can do, I can go to the design option and select this particular table and just expand it a little bit to increase the space. And for the product also, you can expand the size. And now if I go back to preview, so you see there is more space available, and here you see the product names are coming in single line. Also, you can save this report in many different formats. For example, I can save this report in PDF. I click on save under the documents. So the report is saved. If I go to documents, so there is a product details report available. These are the details of accessories, and these are the details of bikes. So you see, if you remember, mountain bikes I have expanded. So you see my report is also appearing in expanded format. But road bikes, I just expanded to one level, so it is showing me black, red, yellow. Clothing also I did not expand, so it did not give me the expanded result. So it means whatever I have expanded, only that thing it is showing me in details, otherwise it is not showing me in details. But Excel supports expand and collapse option. So if I go to save as Excel and I save this report, and if I go to product details, so you see Excel has expand collapse options like this. So only Excel sheet supports expand collapse option, but other options like PDF or image format, they don't support expand collapse option. So whatever is expanded, only that much expansion you can see in the report. If you enjoy this video, please click the like button, and please subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos, and please check the links below for one-to-one online training and more information for SQL Server and BI technology training.